Lewis Gary, when you were reciting all the animals roaming this 6,000 acres, the only one I heard you did not mention was Bigfoot. He's probably out there somewhere. Y'all, I'm delighted to be here. This is another great step forward for South Carolina. And like Elizabeth Taylor once said to her sixth husband, I won't keep you long. But there are a few things that, from my point of view, that I'd like to say. And that is that South Carolina's on the way up, and this is just another example of it. We have all the assets with great research universities that are combining with great companies to do all sorts of research and combinations, and the ideas and innovations just trickle down for entrepreneurs to take advantage of and start going. We've got a great environment, the mountains and oceans and rivers and all that. A great port is getting greater, going to 52 feet. It'll allow two-way traffic 24 hours a day of those big ships, some of which I think carry as many as 19,000 of those transportation units on the back of them. The best technical college system in the whole world. And that's an area where we have to work more to enhance what they're doing. They're doing it very well. But the jobs are changing. The technical nature and the sophistication are changing all around the world as well as here. And there are jobs out there right now that didn't exist 30 years ago. We were at a plant the other day, and we walked in, and the place was clean as a whistle, all sorts of sophisticated equipment and tools and new materials. And the people that build the tools and that build the dies for the presses, and it's just the technology and sophistication is off the scale. The man said that their maintenance technicians all have traded in their toolboxes for laptops. That's the way we're going. So this company and others like it that have made South Carolina home are going to lead us into a great, great future. And our main job, as I see it, is to use an apprenticeship program to explain to people and encourage them to take those jobs, some of which started $75,000 or $100,000 a year. It didn't even exist a few years ago. So South Carolina is on the move. I'll say briefly, in this position, I get to meet a lot of people. And they come from all over the world, and they're looking for places to do business. And they come through the office, and we talk about these things I just mentioned. But somewhere in the conversation, it always comes up. And also in the big companies that you hear of, big ones like BMW, and Mercedes, and Continental, and all of those, somewhere in the conversation, it always comes up that the thing that made the critical difference was the people. It's the people of South Carolina. For whatever reason, those of us that have been here for a while, those of us that haven't been here long, once we get here, we become something very special, and that's a South Carolinian. And there's a special hope, a special trust, a special confidence, and a special friendliness that makes us different. We're determined, willing to work, smart, and this is really a great place. So what I have to say is we're on the way up. We do have a great team. It's been my pleasure to work with these members of the House and Senate, especially the Senate, for the last 2 years. It took a lot of watching of those guys and girls in the House and the Senate. But we do have a great team, and our business community is coherent. We're all aimed in the same direction, and people tell us, these companies that I speak to in this position, say you can get things done quicker in South Carolina than any other place in the whole country. And that's because we know each other, we trust each other. The families go back for many generations in some cases. I remember somebody asked once, said, I have a legal question. What's that? Said, if I'm married in South Carolina and divorced in Georgia, are we still cousins? Well, we're all cousins. And we're all in it together. And I promise you from what I see, if we use our heads and don't make mistakes with too many regulations and too many taxes, we're on the way up and the rest of the country can't keep up with us. And especially with this company, the Cooper River and BP, it reminds me of something that Christy Todd Whitley told me years ago at a conference. We were at the Capital City Club in Columbia looking out the window. It's 26 stories high. And looking down on the university, down at South Carolina, down on the State House, and then beyond that out on the Congaree, and you could see the Broad and the Saluda Rivers and all the green and the farmland. It was just beautiful. And I mentioned to her some of these assets that South Carolina has that we're all so proud of. And she says, and I said, we really do have it all. And she said, do you remember, she was the governor of New Jersey for 8 years. They don't do things in New Jersey quite as carefully as we do it here. And she was also the head of the EPA under George W. Bush for 3 years. So I said, we've really got it all here, and we're making great progress, going to the top. And she says, yes, I believe you will if you don't mess it up. Well, BP is not messing it up. BP here, this, I have rarely gone to an event like this over many, many years where we have heard the CEO speak in such terms about the animals and about nature. And that's one of the most important things we have, is what you see out here. We can have great businesses, great industry, great progress without disturbing a very great natural resource, because that's one reason people come here, that and the people. So I'm here to applaud what you're doing. We wish you great success. We look forward to working with you, and I have a gift to commemorate the occasion. This is a brass plate. It looks just like that. It looks just like the seal. And the seal says, you see the Palmetto logs, that refers to the battle in the Revolutionary War, and which we won, by the way, South Carolina declared its independence of Britain before the rest of the colonies. Yeah, we're way ahead of everybody else. And overhead says, Dum Spiro Spiro, and that is Latin for while I breathe, I hope. And that's what we're all doing. As long as we're breathing, we're hoping for a greater and greater future, and I can promise everybody the best is yet to come. Thank you.